Microsoft. Our call of the day today. Why? Because JPMorgan.
Let's remember, it's not a FANG, right?
Right. That's what I'm saying. It's been a port, if you will, in the big cap tech storm, if you even want to say there was one. Price target raised at JPMorgan to 125, on pace for its best first quarter since 2012.
Well, when you look at the combination of everybody was so against him because of the heart.
Right.
Satya's been doing an unbelievable job. He continues to. And when they, I think the one thing that people are losing sight of is they are steadily kind of picking away at AWS. AWS has got them beat right now in terms of what their percentage of the market is, but they're kind of eating away at that, Scott. And I think that's something that needs to be watched very closely because as they do, these guys, that's the area where I think they can make the most.
They're managing the transition to the cloud better than
anybody. It's not only managing. I mean, this guy is absolutely, the day he took over, the pivot began, and gaming. I mean, we talk about this company, it sounds ridiculous, but you look at the gaming aspect of it and the hardware outside of cloud. This is a company that's on all three fronts doing an unbelievable job.
It's beaten every FANG stock in performance over 1 year. Okay, it's up 30.5%. The closest competitor is Netflix. We know about that, up 24, as Joe was talking about. Google's only up 16. Apple's only up 13. Amazon, not to 23, is, you know, bad by any stretch, but it's still below Microsoft. And then Facebook's up 8.5.
And I think it's fair to categorize Microsoft when you measure it against those names and the other large cap technology type of names. It's fair to say it's got a little bit of a defensive structure to it just because of that software inclusion. And software seems to be, on the CapEx side, the last thing that the enterprise space is giving up when they view the economy as contracting. It also, Microsoft offers a much lower beta versus the names that you're mentioning there. And I think the investment community wants that style and strategy right
now. If you look at Microsoft versus Alphabet, you'll see a very expensive stock. They're selling at roughly the same multiple. Microsoft's even a little more expensive with only 10% growth, maybe accelerating. However, it's much more analyzable. It doesn't have the negative headlines. So you're paying for predictable subscription growth.